Today I am going to explain you about the Ahuja amplifier, how to check the defects and what are the components you need to look into it. You have two amplifiers here. Right now this amplifier is rectified and working alright. The other one I am showing you what went wrong and what is the defect which you have to look into. Normally what happens is due to power fluctuation, this is the bridge rectifier. This bridge rectifier becomes defective. So we have got four connections here. So in this you can always see there will be a plus marking there for the AC here. So the red one is the phase and the other one is the neutral. This is the AC and the output will be this two LO. This is the DC which will be coming. In case there is defective, the DC output will not come. Then you have to change the rectifier. This rectifier, you can see there are marking here. You can see I put a mark here. This is the red and this is the yellow. So you can see AC plus. So they put the AC, you have to connect it red here and the black here. And both the yellow should be connected here. This is one part of the defect. Once that is rectified, then you will get the power. So most of the time what happens, the volume control, this is the volume control. This gets defective. So because of this you will not get the output also. So this is one part of it. You change this volume control. Other than that, you have to see any of the components. You can see here you got resistors, diodes, capacitors. You have to have overall look any of these parts are damaged. If that is that, then you have to change that. So more or less very important thing is first you check the power. Once you get the power, then you check the volume control. These two are very important if normally normal conditions. Other conditions are, it can be defective due to other components also. So if you have any doubt, I will be explaining you. What you have to do is you have a multimeter here, keep it on the diode mode and check the condition of the bridge rectifier. Once you check, you can see if it is defective, you change with the new one. So other thing is you can check the output coming from the bridge rectifier using the multimeter, how much voltage should be coming, you can check that. If you have any doubt regarding this, you can message me. Thank you.